Good morning, students. In this session, we will discuss a new module. In this module, we have to study in detail about three phylum, that is phylum Platyhelminthes, then phylum Nematoda, then phylum Annelida. Okay, so in this module, you have to study in detail about these three phylum, and each phylum has certain classes. Okay. Under phylum Platyhelminthes, you have to study three main classes. That is, first is class Turbellaria, then class Trematoda, and class Cystoda. Okay. So we will move on to the session. The members of phylum Platyhelminthes are commonly known as flatworms. Okay. Their common term is flatworms. They are called so because their body is dorso-ventrally flattened. So, adinte male bhagavum taazhuthathe layer okke completely flattened aayittulla organism aanu. Okay, adondaanu adine flatworm nu parayunnathu. All the members of phylum Platyhelminthes are commonly called flatworm because their dorso-ventral surface is flattened. Okay, and here I have provided some diagrams. These are the members of phylum Platyhelminthes, and here you can see the structure of Planaria. This is a member of class Turbellaria, which comes under phylum Platyhelminthes. Okay, class Turbellaria de oru member aanu, it is called Planaria. And next to Planaria, you can see Fasciola hepatica, or it is also known as liver fluke. Okay, kettittundavu ningalu. And this organism belongs to the class Trematoda. Then next to liver fluke, you can find tapeworm, which is its scientific name is Tinea solium. Okay, Tinea solium, and it comes under the class Cestoda, which belongs to the phylum Platyhelminthes. Okay, these are some of the members of phylum Platyhelminthes. I will tell, this is Planaria. This is liver fluke, or it is called Fasciola hepatica. Its scientific name is Fasciola hepatica. Then this is Tinea solium, which is also known as tapeworm. Okay. So moving on to the phylum features, flatworms are unsegmented organisms, but there are exceptions. Here in this figure, you can see the structure of Platyhelminthes and liver fluke, in which when we check the body or structure of Platyhelminthes and liver fluke, you cannot find segments. Segments are absent, and hence they are called unsegmented animals. Okay, but there are exceptions. While we check the structure of tapeworm or Tinea solium, we can see segments. Okay, and each of these segments that you find in Tinea solium are called proglottis. Okay, the segments in Tinea solium of tapeworm are called proglottis. Most of the members of phylum Platyhelminthes are unsegmented, but there are exceptions. And the members of Platyhelminthes are bilaterally symmetrical. We have already discussed about the symmetry, that is symmetry are of different types, bilateral symmetry and radial symmetry. But members of Platyhelminthes possess bilateral symmetry. That is, we can divide that particular organism into two different halves only in a single plane. ഒരൊറ്റ പ്ലെയിനിൽ വെച്ചിട്ട് നമ്മൾ ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ നമുക്ക് ഈക്വൽ ടു ഹാഫ്സ് കിട്ടുന്ന ടൈപ്പ് സിമെട്രിയാണ് നമ്മൾ ബയലാട്രൽ സിമെട്രി എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അല്ലേ, റേഡിയൽ സിമെട്രി ആണെങ്കിലോ ഏത് പ്ലെയിനിൽ നമുക്ക് ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാലും ഈക്വൽ ഹാഫ് കിട്ടുന്ന സിമെട്രിനെ നമ്മൾ റേഡിയൽ സിമെട്രി എന്ന് പറയും. പക്ഷേ ഈ പ്ലാറ്റിഹെൽമിൻസിലൊക്കെ ഒരൊറ്റ പ്ലെയിനിൽ, ഈ ഒരു പ്ലെയിനിൽ ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ മാത്രമേ നമുക്ക് രണ്ട് ഈക്വൽ ഹാഫ് നമുക്ക് കിട്ടത്തുള്ളൂ. ഇങ്ങനെ ഡിവൈഡ് ചെയ്ത് കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ ഈക്വൽ ഹാഫ് കിട്ടത്തില്ല. ഓക്കെ, സോ മെമ്പേഴ്സ് ഓഫ് ദിസ് ഫൈലം പൊസസ് ബയലാട്രൽ സിമെട്രി, ആൻഡ് ദെയർ ബോഡി ഈസ് ഡോർസോ വെൻട്രലി ഫ്ലാറ്റഡ്, ആൻഡ് ദേ ആർ ട്രിപ്ലോബ്ലാസ്റ്റിക് ആനിമൽസ്. ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് വൺ ഓഫ് ദ മെയിൻ ഫീച്ചർ ഓഫ് Platyhelminthes, that is, their body consists of three layers. Okay, their body possesses three layers, that is outer ectoderm, then inner endoderm, and in between the outer ectoderm and inner endoderm, it possesses a middle mesoderm. Okay, such kind of organisms are called triploblastic animals. Okay, from platyhelminths to the higher order of animal kingdom, you can find triploblastic animals. So they are triploblastic animals in which it, they possess ectoderm and outer ectoderm, then inner endoderm and the middle mesoderm layer. And flatworms are acoelomates. Acoelomates mean, coelom means body cavity. Okay, body cavity is also called a coelom. That term is coelom. Coelom means body cavity. But flatworms doesn't possess body cavity. That means the outer ectoderm and inner endoderm, and in between these two layers there is no space. Okay, you cannot find any coelom or any body cavity. Body cavity is absent. But in between these two layers you can find a mesodermal tissue, and that particular mesodermal tissue is called the mesenchyme or parenchyma. Okay, that is the space between the ectoderm and endoderm is actually filled with a special type of mesodermal tissue, and that tissue is called mesenchyme or parenchyme. Clear? So flatworms are acoelomates. That means a true coelom or body cavity is absent, and in between the ectoderm and inner endoderm it possesses a mesodermal tissue that is called mesenchyme or parenchyma. Okay, and another unique feature of this platyhelminthes is they possess cephalization. Cephalization means the existence of a prominent head region at its anterior portion. Okay, you can find in planaria at the anterior tip of its body you can find a head portion. Okay, this is a head region. And in case of fasciola also you can find a head like, not head like, it is the head region, and it is very distinct in genia solium. You can find the anterior portion which is called the scolex. Okay, this is the head portion. Okay, so the main feature of the phylum platyhelminthes is they possess or they exhibit cephalization. Cephalization means the anterior end of the body is differentiated into a distinct head. And some members are free living and some members of this phylum are parasitic. As I have already shown the structure of planaria, planaria is a free living form, that is it is non-parasitic. While in case of the liver fluke and genia solium, they are parasitic. Genia solium or tapeworm can even infect, or it may cause some problems to the humans also. Genia solium mainly infect the muscles of the pig, and it can be transmitted to the human, and human act as a definitive host. So that is why some members are free living, but many are parasitic. Example for free living is planaria, then parasitic forms are liver fluke and tinea solium. And they lack elementary canal, but there are exceptions. Even elementary canal are absent in case of parasitic forms, but elementary canal is present in case of free living forms. In free living platyhelminthes, the elementary canal is branched and it may open into a single opening. While we check the structure of a planaria, you can find the mouth part and some of the elementary canal region. While when we look on to the internal structures of liver fluke and tinea, you cannot find the elementary canal. Elementary canal is completely absent. But in case of free living forms, elementary canal is present and it is branched and it opens to a single opening, that is the mouth, and it doesn't have anus. Okay, anus is absent. The excretion and the osmoregulation, all these functions are performed by a distinct pair of cell which is called the protonephridia or flame cell. This is the structure of flame cell, and this particular cell carry out the excretion and osmoregulation. Okay, this is a single cell. Here is the cell body of the cell, and here you can find the nucleus. These are vacuoles. These are small vacuoles. You can find vacuoles in the cell body, and these are cell processes, or we will call cell extensions or cytoplasmic processes. Okay, and here these are cilia of the cell, which is called ciliary flame, and this region is the excretory duct, which is called intercellular duct. Here you can see the intracellular duct, which is commonly called excretory duct. It is a single cell which carry out the function of excretion and osmoregulation in flatworms or members of phylum Platyhelminthes. This point is very important, that is the function of protonephridia or flame cell. Flame cells are present in the members of phylum Platyhelminthes, and their major function is excretion and osmoregulation. And flatworms lack respiratory or circulatory system. As I have already told you that they lack elementary canal, and when the pre-living forms possess elementary canal. In case of flatworms, they completely lack respiratory and also the circulatory system. But these functions are played by the respiratory function and also circulatory system function are played by their body wall. Okay. Flatworms lack respiratory or circulatory system. These functions are performed through their body wall. And they possess muscles for their movement. Muscles help a lot. That is, the movement of flatworms is controlled by different types of muscle. That is, they possess longitudinal muscle, then circular muscle, and oblique layers of muscles. Okay. And another feature is some members of flatworms possess ocelli. Okay, here you can see small dark eye spots. These eye spots are called ocelli. Okay, and it is very important. The function of ocelli is to perceive the light. Okay, and the head region possess light sensitive organ which called ocelli, and it is very distinct in case of planaria. When we check the anterior head region of planaria, you can see eye-like structure, or it is called eye spot, and the main function is to perceive the light or for light sensitization. Okay, it acts as a light sensitive organ, and it some members also possess some other sense organ, such as chemoreceptors. They possess chemoreceptors. Then statocyst helps in balancing. Okay, statocyst is a balance receptor, and in some members they are also present rioreceptors. Rioreceptors help in the reception of water movement. Okay, some members are able to identify the water movement with the help of the rioreceptors. But these sense organs are present only in few members. Not all members of Platyhelminthes possess these receptors. It is very peculiar that only certain members of phylum Platyhelminthes possess these receptors. Okay. So other sense organs found in some members of this group include chemoreceptors, then statocyst, and rioreceptors, and most of the flatworms are hermaphrodites. Okay, hermaphrodite means the male and female sex organs are present in the same individual. Such kind of organism is called a hermaphrodite, and they reproduce sexually and asexually. So that's all about phylum, characteristic feature of phylum. Clatchy Helminthus.